Aloha and good morning. Dr. Robert Cassar here with EarthShiftProducts.com and EarthAcademy.com. Wait until you see the cut that I got on my leg, my knife wound accident. This is a 30-day journey. I'm going to show with you how I healed rapidly without infection using terrain modification protocols. The question is, what if you got a big wound, a cut, okay, some type of infection? How would you attend to this without professional intervention? I didn't use sutures, I didn't use antibiotics, steri strips, or pain meds. Okay, so part one is going to go with you over a lecture and ideas, and part two is all the practices, protocols, and principles that we don't show on YouTube, but wait until you see, wow, what a journey I went on. Okay, guys, hugs for everyone. Enjoy the film. Aloha and good afternoon. Well, this is a continuation of the rapid wound healing series. Why? Because I've got myself another wound. As you can see, we've got blood on the towel, and I just went ahead and cut myself really good. We were moving, we have another farm over in Hawaii here, in Waimea, and we were unloading a 45-foot container. And this knife right here did a job on me, okay? And it cut me in my ankle about 2 inches wide, right down to the bone, okay? Cut my veins in there and everything, and boy did I bled like a stuck pig. So anyways, also my thumb here also got wounded really bad. And I'll tell you about the story here, it's real simple. I went over to check out the gas that we have over there. It's a big gas tank, 500 gallons. And we didn't have any gas in the stove, and the hot water wasn't working. So I went over there to go ahead and check on the gas. And I banged the side of the tank to be able to listen to how much gas is in it. And of course, once I did that, there was a couple of hornets that came out, and they were really pissed, and they went ahead and bit me. And I had my knife in my hand. I was just hitting the side of the tank. But as I did, this knife flips open. It's very dangerous, okay? My son Weston gave this to me for my birthday. And it's super sharp. You can see it's very serrated, okay? It's a very, it's a pocket knife, but this is a very dangerous pocket knife. And the knife flew open. It cut my hand open right here, okay? As you can see, really deep. Bled like crazy, and the knife fell down, and of course you can see this thing's got a cut here that would really, once it slides, it cuts, and it cut my, let me show you here, cut my ankle so good, and my whole foot was full of blood. Oh, so I'm gonna go ahead and show you what I'm gonna do to fixing wounds. Okay, I should go to the hospital right now and probably go ahead and get 25 stitches. Yeah, everybody told me. They said, oh my gosh, they turned away and looked, you know, and I said, oh shit, it's pretty good, huh? So, you know, these types of wounds, okay, you can do what you want. A lot of people don't have health insurance. Well, here's one of the ways. I have really good health insurance, but I'm not going to go ahead and sit in the hospital and go ahead and take whatever they want to give me and get maybe 25 stitches in there, which is going to irritate the tissues. And since it was cut with a knife that's very sharp and not jagged, then I'm going to go ahead and actually mend the tissue together very rapidly, just like I did on my face on the prior one. It's been about probably 2 months right now, and you can see you don't even have a scar. I had a huge cut right here, another huge cut here, and another huge cut right across here. It ran into a pole. And we're gonna use the same exact recipe that I did, but I'm gonna show you how to use it on my ankle wound. So I'm gonna change camera views here. We'll unwrap this thing and see what it looks like. I did put some hydrogen peroxide on it first just to be able to kill the infection, because I've been cutting open, we had a 45-foot container full of furniture and full of stuff, and I'm cutting open all the tape and everything else. What do you think's on this blade? Everything and everything. So let me switch the camera up here and I'll show you what I'm doing. All right. Okay, here we go. I'm gonna go ahead and show you what is underneath my ankle here. And this knife just fell from 3 feet down and it went like this across my ankle right here. Okay, and it cut right down to the tendon. I could see the white tendon inside there. Remember, these are wounds. They're not just cuts. A wound is where you can go ahead and look inside and you can say, wow, this is a machine. Okay, so let me put this right here, refocus here. And I had my 5-finger shoes on. Oh, you can see. And this whole sock, if it was white, oh, is wet and soaked right now. Full of, oh. Oh, it smells like blood too. It smells irony. And my blood, remember, it's got a nice color to it. It's like sort of burgundy. Okay, that's healthy blood. Not red blood, burgundy blood. Oh, and I also, you can see back here, show you a close-up of that one. My heel here, I went ahead and stepped on a nail and it's got a bad infection. I'm gonna have to lance that too. So that's gonna be another part of the video here. And ouch, that's got an infection in there. And I did step on a rusty nail and that's not good. And we're gonna treat that also. So I'm gonna take this off here, which what I did was I put pressure on it, okay, to be able to stop the bleeding. And this thing was bleeding like crazy before, okay? And you can see the cut's already healed. I heal very quickly, okay? But this is totally open and ugly. You should have saw this thing before, okay? This thing was open and you can see I stretched it apart and you could see inside my tendons and you can see the stained blood around here. Okay, so what we're gonna do is I'm gonna treat my foot. What I did first put on it though, first aid, was I put hydrogen peroxide, only 3%, even less than that, just to be able to clean the wound, because remember the knife was dirty, maybe the rusty nail, whatever it was, there's a lot of bacteria. Remember, one tooth has about 7 billion bacteria on it, okay? Good, bad, in between, it's bacteria. Bacteria's everywhere, it's in the air, okay? It's on your skin, it's in your mouth, okay? It's in your food. Is it good bacteria or is it bad bacteria? So, anyways, I did a foot protocol here last night and I soaked my foot. You can see how this right here is, oh, and there's a piece that went deep inside and it actually jammed inside my bone there. So it's all an experiment. Remember, you can go to the hospital, you can do their side of the fence, or you can go ahead and experiment yourself and see if you can fix it yourself. And if you can't, then go to the hospital, okay? Maybe you should have went to the hospital first, okay? Maybe you shouldn't. Maybe you could have figured it out yourself. So these are just some ways that I'm gonna show you. We're gonna go over in part two. Part two will be on Earther Academy, and Earther Academy has hundreds of private, not open to the public, very sensitive videos on detoxification and rejuvenation protocols, okay? In over 50 departments. And of course, there's lots of videos, so, you know, it's gonna take lots of time to be able to absorb a lot of the information that makes sense to your brain, okay, right now. But once you clean the body, okay, once you clean the holy temple, okay, once you get this thing clean, then your mind becomes clean. And we go over lots of different types of protocols, practices, and principles for you to be able to just upgrade, enhance, and optimize your world. You can see I do have some products right here, and I'm gonna go over these here, and we're gonna go through all of them. And this is what I'm gonna use to regenerate my wound, and not only regenerate it, but also make it so, well, it'll heal without a scar, just like my face did. I had a huge cut right here. Look up Dr. Robert Cassar, Rapid Wound Healing. Okay, huge here, here, and here. And I should have had a plastic surgeon go ahead and, because if not, I wind up getting cuts. I've already broke my nose about 5 times. I've smashed my face, broke my cheek, cracked my teeth, got into massive car accidents with my face, okay? So I've only found these techniques is because I have had deficiencies in these areas. Okay, so I'm glad I got this cut right now so I can show you guys. Okay, what would you do, okay, if you had a cut? I don't know. What would you do if you had a cut and you didn't, well, live in the sort of civilized world? What if you lived in the Amazon? It's where I learned a lot of this information. What if you lived in a place that doesn't have, well, doctors, but they have medicine doctors, okay? Not synthetic medicine doctors, but natural medicinal doctors. Natural. They use the plants and all the different types of flora, fauna, whatever they can go ahead and get in the natural world, not chemicals. Okay, no radiation, no cutting things out. And if that, of course, you have to have those things, then get them done. Now, I'm going to go over, like I said, in part two, I'm going to go over the protocols of what I would do if I had myself a really severe wound. Okay, what would you do to stop it? Okay, and what would you do after that you had this wound? Okay, what would you do? I would probably run to the hospital. Okay, but then again, sometimes you don't have the availability of the hospital. That's why you need an Earth Shift kitchen, not only to be able to upgrade, enhance, and optimize your kitchen, but also to optimize, enhance, and upgrade your, well, you can see, this is my bathroom right here, okay? And I've got this set up, and I've got all these products, and these products, when used in combination, are very smart, okay? You can just do water fasting, which we talked to people about a lot, okay? You can cut down on your sugar. You can increase your exercise. You can get a shower chlorinator, okay? You can change your detergents. But what are you going to do to be able to deaccumulate all of the microbial loads that you have that are not essential for your health and wealth and being, okay, parasitical loads? What are you going to do with the heavy metal loads, the plastics, okay? Everything that you could imagine that basically gets stuck in your filter. What are you going to do to be able to get that out? Just because you clean your food source doesn't mean that your body's going to go ahead and be efficient. Most likely it's clogged. Most likely your skin's clogged. Most likely you need a rebuild, just like buying a fixer-upper house or buying a car that basically you got a great deal on, but wow, you got to go ahead and do some work on it or put some love into it. And you're going to have to put some love into your body, okay? So get yourself a companion. And these are all little pieces of the pie, okay? All little pieces of the pie. We're going to show you how I use white willow bark extract, pure hydrogen peroxide, activated charcoal, okay? Iodine, fulvic, living silica, magnesium, DMSO, neem oil, niacin, ascorbic acid, and different types of copper sulfates, copper salicylates, and different types of things that I made myself. Remember, these are standards in your house. Standards. Okay? When you get a wound, when you get an infection, well, you know what? Better figure it out. These are all remedies that I've found out that actually really do work, and they only will work, okay, in your mind when you have to use them. Like right now, I just got myself, like I said, oh, and I had to leave. You can see right now, I just stretched it out a little bit and it's bleeding, okay? I took off the compression that I had, and this thing needs to get healed, okay? And this is what I'm going to do. All right, here we go. Part three. Okay. Okay, here's about 12 hours after. And you can see, nice job, huh? So this will be a very fast wound healing event, and you can see how it's already making its matrix there of new tissue. And let me just show you the bottom of my foot that I went ahead and also punctured, and I took out the big piece of glass in there, and that was really a bleeder. So, okay, and there you go. Wow. Aloha and good morning. I'm going to give you a little update on my injury that I had. And boy, was that a good cut. Remember, Friday morning, I dropped a knife on my leg and I cut it, a long gash, right down to the tendons. Not into the tendons, but it cut the hole. I could pull the flesh apart and really look inside, and you can see everything inside there. And it was just gushing out, not just bleeding, it was gushing. So this is another, of course, big question. What would you do if you got cut and you couldn't go to the hospital, you couldn't do anything? I could have went to the emergency, I could have went and got probably about 20 stitches. But what I'm doing is actually trying different types of, on myself, of course, it's everything's an experiment, but I'm trying different types of rapid wound healings when I, of course, personally get a wound. Okay, I cut my thumb severely deep. It's already mostly healed. And remember, we live in Hawaii. Everybody here gets staph a lot of times. Flesh-eating bacteria, in fact, of really bad, uncurable. They can't even go ahead and get rid of it, some people have. So that's the biggest, biggest threat in a place that doesn't have that much dirt. Hawaii doesn't have that much dirt on the Big Island, so you get a lot of different bacteria that grow on the rocks. So scratching your leg up against the rock, going in the water, feces, whatever you can get all different types of infections, okay? So this is not only for cuts, but this is for infections also, okay? So yesterday, I felt it real deep, okay? I felt it really healing, okay? You're gonna see, pretty much amazed here, just how fast, and remember, this thing was a gusher, and this is how I sealed it up last night. This is a breathable cotton gauze, of course, it's just a sock. And yesterday I kept it all open all day. And let me just peel, I need two hands here. So let's just, peel this back. And I put, and you can see here, wow. Oh, it's looking beautiful. Okay, let me get my sock off. And of course, this is on a bad spot here too. Okay, look at that, beautiful healing already. Okay, no swelling, nothing. And I'm gonna show you what I did, because I used a magnetic generator, which is very important to be able to go ahead and actually remunerate the cellular structure that's been damaged. And this also has an effect on microbial inactivity. Okay, so you can see, just putting a close up there, okay, very healed, doesn't hurt at all, okay. I did last night, I soaked my feet. I'll have to show you the solution, okay, both sides. And this is a necessary cleaning that everybody should do once a month, but this is gonna suck out all the inflammation. I also put, I'll show you, pure ascorbic acid in there, and I also put pure white willow bark, okay? So I'll go over that with you, but I just wanted to show you. Okay, it's not even been 2 days yet, okay? And I can walk around. Yesterday, I couldn't walk too good, okay? But today, just in that time frame, okay, and remember, it's on my ankle. It wants to split open all the time. That's why they would do what? Put stitches on it, okay? Do you see any steri strips or anything? No, I don't have anything on there. It's just healed itself already, okay? And like I said, I used the iodine. I put the fulvic acid on. I put the silica on, okay? Put the magnesium on. Wow, did that burn? Okay, let it all move inside, okay? You could add DMSO to that if you had an infection. I put copper, okay, on there with the iron, with the fulvic acid. I went over this before, but I'll go over this again and I'll show you, this is just what I did. You can do whatever you want to do, but it does work, okay? It does work. This was a gash the other day, okay? And of course it doesn't hurt at all. It doesn't sting, doesn't burn, doesn't bleed, okay? So I use the same technique right here on my thumb too. Remember on my face the other day, I cut myself from here to here. I should have took 20 stitches through here, okay? That was completely healed in a week, okay? It would take weeks to do that. Again, one last look here. not even 2 days yet, and I can bend it forward and backwards. It doesn't want to pull apart, okay? And there's no swelling or anything on there, okay? Usually you'd have swelling this big, okay? Yes, you would, an infection massively. It's down by your feet. It's got everything around you. You go to the hospital, what are they gonna do? They're gonna give you antibiotics, okay? Maybe even a tetanus shot, maybe even something else too. So you can topically go ahead and actually, you know, not only disinfect things, but make it so the microbes, remember it's the microbes that get on top of the sore that make it so it can't heal. Okay, so if we make it so that terrain cannot accept, okay, flesh-eating bacteria, then the tissue will grow back rapidly. Okay, rapidly. But it needs the right minerals, silica, magnesium, conductive minerals. Okay, we've gone over this lots of times. Remember, life's an experiment. Okay, I'm just showing you what I'm doing. Okay, like I said. I also used, like I said, in my solution, I use TSP. Okay, I put a spoon of TSP in there. I put two spoons of TSP, two spoons of borax. Okay, that's laundry detergent, 20 meal power team. I put in 2 grams in each bag. This is in each bag of ascorbic acid, 2 grams of white willow bark in each side. Okay, and that's of course in my alcohol solution. It's got alcohol in there and hydrogen peroxide. So that is very magical. Forget about getting your flow better and everything, but just taking off the calluses and stopping toe fungus and all different types of toxicities that are in your feet. Remember your feet, your mouth, your hands, okay, and your gut. Those are one of the biggest, you know, areas that you need to go ahead and take care of. Remember we went over how to go ahead and seal and refix your gums, okay? Harden your enamel, okay? How to rebuild your gut wall flora. It's a not must. If you don't do that, you're not gonna get healthy. Remember all your B vitamins, your brain chemicals, your hormones, everything's pretty much made in your stomach, 90% of your genome's down there. So, and that's it. I just wanted to show you just a little bit, just taking you day by day, just to go ahead and verify and show you. Rapid wound healing is real, okay? How you do it? Well, there's lots of different ways, but I have used magnets. I've used the magnetic generator. Okay, it shoots a million mile an hour pulse. I showed how to use that before. It's on our suppressed technologies video we have on Earther Academy. And you can use a variety of different types of fungal disinfectants, okay, fungal. We make our own copper, and you can mix it with ascorbate acid, okay, which is vitamin C, and you get copper ascorbate. Okay, you can mix that with aspirin and you get copper salicylates, pain analgesic, beautiful one. Okay, so there's all different things that you could go ahead and change, okay? What we call your terrain. Remember, flesh-eating bacteria only eat on the terrain is because they can. So what do? Make it so they can't. Okay, again, one last look, because I'm sort of amazed also. I worked in the hospital for 7 years, okay? This isn't happening. Just think, I would have had stitches all the way through here. I would have had a Band-Aid. I would have had pharmaceuticals, pain pills, okay? Antibiotics, okay? What a hamster wheel, okay? Remember, become your own doctor if you can, if you want to try, okay? I'm not telling you what to do, remember. I'm not telling you, you're not as we say, and, you know, becoming your own doctor, watch that film. Remember, I'm my own doctor, I'm not yours, okay? I'm just showing you what I do, and if it's reasonable and logical, then give it a try. And if it's, you know, changeable a little bit, change it up. Remember, it's a work in progress. Okay, guys, aloha. I'm gonna go jump in the shower. And I'm just gonna take a steam shower right now. It's gonna get wet and everything else, and I'm gonna put on, I'll come back and I'll show you how I'm gonna dress it up again. Remember, I'm gonna keep this potion that I'm putting on there to make it so it regenerates rapidly, so no bacteria gonna get on there and or try to get into my bone, okay? I felt it in my bone yesterday. In fact, it was sore, okay? That's why I soaked, and I also put ice in the bag to be able to cool it down. So I'll go over all that procedure and protocol, okay? If you do wind up getting pain, rheumatoid arthritis, any types of things, you can use this aspirin with copper, and it does magic, okay? So, okay. Aloha. Okay, now I'm going to show you how I'm going to fit my new dressing, okay? New dressing, okay? Remember, when you get a wound, they say you put a dressing on it, okay? Just like sort of like a dressing on your salad, okay? So this is a recipe, it's a dressing, okay? It's a potion. And it's specifically to make sure, number one, flesh-eating bacteria does not go back into my wound, does not want to get in because it can't. Remember, the terrain's not right. Okay, so I want to not only disinfect it if there is, but I want to make sure that there's a guard up to make sure that they can't get in. Remember, viruses and different infections come in through cuts in our body, cuts through our gums, cuts in our hands and our feet. Okay, this is how a lot of things get in. They pierce our body armor. Remember, your body armor is your skin. Okay, it protects us from the outside world. So, you know, there are ways to be able to do things alternatively to what the normal mainstream people do. Remember, what would you do if you didn't have a doctor? You'd become your own doctor. You'd go ahead and get guidance from other people that have sort of done this too, and that's what doctors are doing. Okay, they only learn what they learn. Okay, but most of the learning that they learn is to be able to see if they could get rid of symptomology, okay? Symptoms, okay? Not the root or the cause of the problem. So remember, we have to be smart and put our own critical thinker hats on, okay? Because a lot of times we need to find out what we need to do, and that's why you have the internet, because you can talk to anybody, you can find out any information, and that's the best part. Remember, critical thinking. Now, I'm going to go through my recipe list again, okay? Why I would use certain things on the first when I get cut versus why I would use things after the heel has wounded, after the blood has stopped bleeding, okay? And you can see I'm going to show you my, this is not even 2 days, okay? And it's pretty much completely sealed. Look, I can bend it back and forth, okay? Look, I can touch it. Okay, this is amazing. I've put coconut oil on my body. Okay, I just got out of the steam shower, got wet and everything. Yesterday I went ahead and took a steam shower, got wet and everything. And a lot of times I'll tell you, don't get the wound wet. Remember, this is a different profile. It's not as what we've learned. And I'm just showing you how it works. But you can see, that was a cut. I could open that thing up. I looked in there and oh my gosh, was that ugly. And again, my thumb. This was a massive cut. Well, not even 2 days ago, okay? And it went in deep. Now, regeneration depends on, real quick here, number one, okay? Did you get the bacteria out of the sore, out of the wound? Okay, why? It's because it's gonna eat that tissue, because that's what flesh-eating bacteria does. Staphylococcus, streptococcus, lots of things eat flesh. Remember, lots of people eat flesh, don't they? Okay, remember, the more flesh you eat, the more parasites you have in your body, the more parasites, remember, you have parasites in your body, you have microbes in your body, not just coming in from the outside, they're coming in from the inside. Once the body inside gets bruised, it winds up getting damaged. That means that the parasites inside the body that are very micro small, they found food, is because now they can get inside, because the protective sheaths and the layers of the inside below the skin. Remember, your body's full of different parasites. If you think it's not, you're only being foolish. But once the body gets damaged inside, it gets a bruise, it gets inflammation in the stomach, anywhere, okay? Then what happens is that now you get a chance for the microbes. It's like, here's a good example. Let's say you're a bike rider, okay, and you're doing 10, 15, 20 mile bike rides all the time, and you're sitting on that hard seat on your prostate, and you're inflaming it. You're causing it not to go ahead and get the blood supply it needs, and you're smashing the heck out of it, okay? Not good. It causes inflammation. If you did it once, well, that's one thing, but you do it all the time, because bike riders, I know, I used to do it every day or three times a week at least. And we go on long rides, okay? And I had to change my seat because it was bugging me so much. And if I borrow my brother's bike, because he likes that hard seat, okay, I can't even ride the bike, okay? So anyways, because it hurts so much down there, and I know what it's doing. See, I know it's causing damage. I know. Inflammation, microbes jump into the inflammation, Okay, and once that happens, then all of a sudden they got life. They're not getting out, they're going in. Okay, they're eating their way in, and it's flesh-eating bacteria. Then your body tries to rebuild it, and it's got to fight off these little parasitic demons. Flesh-eating bacteria demons, okay? So, anyways, you know, philosophy is the biggest thing. If you want to learn how to be able to not fight things, but how to be able to actually navigate things is the question at hand. It's not to fight. It's not to try to poison parasites. It's not to try to go against something in your body. You're trying to terrain modify it. You're trying to upgrade, enhance, and optimize everything you do. Okay, remember I showed you a little while ago, my face. Look up Dr. Robert Cassar, rapid healing. And my face, I cut it here, here, and here. It's on my face. I should add scars, okay? It's only been not even a month and a half, maybe 2 months, not even that. Okay, and in not even a week, that thing was totally healed. No stitches, nothing. I even broke my bone and that thing was sticking out that far. I showed you pictures of it. So I'm glad I have these types of injuries because you know why? I'm not doing the traditional way of treatment. What I'm doing is I'm looking at different ways that normal people, anybody can do. Remember, it's all experiment. I'm not showing you, you know, what to do. I'm showing you what I do. And of course, it's just a work in progress. Okay, we're going to start this next part, but I want to show you, okay? Guys, if you watch the Earth Academy videos, there's lots of good nectar on there, okay? It's not as organized as it should be, but there's a lot of information, and a lot of the information gets said again in different ways. It gets looked at over here, but looked down at this way. It's looked up over here, and it looks down this way, okay? From RF frequencies, invisible ethereal poison, okay? Which is Wi-Fi, Wi-Fi, all the different electrical magnetics. These are all pieces you need to not, you know, fight. You need to navigate, okay? And your body, remember, is weak to this energy. It's because it's constant. It's constant. So it works it after a while. Better figure out how to not only ground yourself, but make sure you go ahead and reset yourself. Okay, and the more heavy metals you have in your body, the more poisons you have in your body, when you get into these electrical frequencies, these Wi-Fi, Wi-Fi, RF frequencies, everybody's got cell phones, everything's in the air, okay? Then any metal, heavy metals, any different types of things in your body other than your organic, okay, tissue, sings through the, think of vibrations going through my body, waves, invisible waves, can't hear them, some people can, I can. They go through, and if my body was super clean, they just go through and they really irritate me, okay? But then again, if you have full of metals, full of different particles, different chemicals, whatever it is, every time the wave hits it, it sends off a vibration, an orchestra of dysfunction in the body because it awakens the lead, the mercury, the cadmium, the aluminum, the arsenic, the pesticides, insecticides, herbicides. Everything that's in there sings the vibration that it is. And it's not your vibration. You think arsenic's good for you? You think cadmium or mercury or anything else or plastic's good for you? No, it's not. Okay, so you have to think. If you're in these waves all the time, okay, wearing big pieces of jewelry and thinking it's looking cool and everything, and rings and big earrings, that's ionization radiation that's in the air, okay? RF frequencies, all different waves, and these are antenna. And all you're doing is you're making yourself dysfunctional, okay? You just are. You should be wearing a crystal all the time, okay? You should. And if you're not, well, it's because you're still calling it a crystal. This is an interdimensional gem, and it does harmonize you, it does energize you, okay? And it does give you what's called equilibrium to some degree, because our system's being whacked with all different types of waves, okay? And it is necessary to learn as much as you can in the terrain modification protocols, okay? Learn what you can, when you can, if you can. You don't even have to change your diet, okay? In the beginning. But if you don't change your diet, then you're missing out. Remember, and how do you change your diet? That's one thing, okay? I would suggest a blood-free diet. We have lots of videos on that, okay? But how do you get out the garbage, the accumulation, the baggage, the plastic, okay? All the different heavy metals, vaccines, all whatever's inside your system that's not supposed to be there. I lost 40 pounds. Look, remember again, I'm an old man, okay? 40 pounds, 56 years old, okay? From here to here, how old am I, okay? How old am I? All right, I'm not 56 years old. Okay, so you can terrain modify and deaccumulate the body, okay? You can, Okay, there are protocols that you have to understand in your head because you accumulate every day. Are you doing anything to deaccumulate, or are you just feeding your face? And you're not even feeding your face, remember, you're feeding your parasites that are telling you to eat that garbage. And once you dry yourself out, learn the intermittent fasting, block fasting, once you dry yourself out, okay, you get freedom. Why? Because all these little parasites that are mind-controlling parasites, we got lots of videos in our Earther Academy series over there, remember it's private, okay? You gotta know the psychology. You have to understand, remember, these parasites are your children. And I'm talking about parasites now is because that flesh-eating bacteria on that wound right now, I'd be in the hospital today, okay? With a big infection, my leg this big around, okay? And it full of pus. Okay, again, look, you see any pus on here? See any infection? Okay, you see anything? No. Do you see any swelling? Does it hurt? No. Okay, not a bit. I can move the tissue back and forth and you can see everything's tight. It's got a glue surface on there. Okay, so anyways, part two, we're gonna do Earther Academy only, but I wanted to show you two people. Guys, there are different ways for you to be able to navigate in this world. Okay, and we should learn from each other. I've been doing this for 35 years. Okay, 35 years. And all I know is the more I know, the less I know. I'm just a student. That's it. I'm only showing you as a student what I'm doing, experimentation-wise, and what I've done with patients who wanted to experiment, wanted to research. As it is every day, you go to the store, you research reading labels. Okay? You research how to comb your hair. Okay? You search. Everybody's looking every day. You're a researcher, no matter what you think you are. You better research some of these areas. Remember, how to live healthy, wealthy, happy, and wise. Wise means you're getting evolution, okay? And evolution is something that you can't even talk about. All you can do is look back at yourself and say, what a maroon I used to be. I say that to myself all the time, okay? I've changed probably 15 lives within this carnation. And people that have known me for a long time, well, they know that I'm not myself anymore, at least the old self, okay? We all grow, and that's depending on your morphogenic field, and your morphogenic field can be down here at the bottom, very low vibration, okay? Or it can be in the middle, green, red, yellow, green, blue, indigo, and violet. These are all colors, they're all tunes, they're all vibrations, color, light, and sound, okay? What your body and your mind becomes is your morphogenic value. The body's energy, it's your battery, it's your conductive battery that holds charge, okay? Your mind is energy plus vibrations, okay? Vibrations, experiences, thought, critical thinking, okay? Are you doing anything good on this planet? Or are you doing destructive things? You know what you're doing, okay? And if you're not, wake up, okay? Energy plus vibrations, energies, okay, the bodies, all of them, vibrations, all the minds, equals consciousness, equals awareness, equals what I call the morphogenic value. What value do you think you have? If you only knew there was a scale to be able to look and see where you want to be, where do you think you want to be? You'd want to be able to activate that whole scale, the whole light spectrum. You're not just jumping to the top. You're not just staying in the middle, green. Remember the rainbow, okay? Yellow brick road, you're going up this layer, but each layer you go up, you encompass the next layer and all the layers from the bottom up become one. That's what you're trying to do, okay? And it is a journey, it is. And in time, you're gonna see, part of your evolution is to be able to help other people with their evolution, okay? That's part of your evolution, it's part of your authenticity is to be able to help anybody who wants help. It's just it. It's coming from here either. It's not from here. Okay, this always has an agenda. This has none. Okay, I try to always speak from my heart. That's it, guys. Okay, and I risk a lot to be able to share with people. It's because for some reason the system doesn't want you to be healthy, wealthy, happy, and wise. And wise means critical thinker. It means maybe quantum thinking. Okay, instead of not even the mainstream, but the lamestream. It's very low level. Remember, that's morphogenic value of red and orange. That's it. And just so you know, look, red is right here, okay? This is the lower chakra. This is survival, sexuality, sin, sorrow, all the different weird things. It's the spell, okay? You need this thing down here.
and this is six cycles per second. This is red, this is orange, this is yellow. This is food, okay? This is a area that feeds, okay, you. Your brain, when this is activated, what does it do? It stimulates your brain to be able to go ahead and think in that tune, okay? So if you're stimulated sexually, do you think your brain's thinking about food? No, because not thinking about mathematics. I'm paying it, thinking about the rent. And if your heart's stimulated, this heart chakra, eight cycles per second, okay? Then what happens? Then your mind is blended with this energy, all these energies, okay? But this isn't just sexuality down there. This isn't just food. These are momentous energies that actually activate each one of the energies that basically we call emotions, okay? And then once you start speaking your truth, you start speaking your truth, okay? This is another chakra right here. Green is the heart. We live on the green plane. That's the earth. And you'll see, if you look it up, the Schumann resonance is eight cycles per second. That's right here. We live on the heart plane, but we don't act like it. Most of us just live in the lower chakras, sexuality, sin, sorrow. Remember, me. They don't see that we're all not one, but we're all connected in the web. And something is breathing us all. Something. That's the miracle of life. Remember, what species on this planet, bird, bee, whale, snail, all the people, every variant DNA, everything that lives in this air, from fish, birds, snakes, reptiles, it's all being breathed, because those animals aren't breathing like you're not breathing. It breathes. Isn't that a miracle? You can breathe, okay? But remember, what breathes you and I and everything else? It's not thinking. You don't think, breathe when you're asleep. Remember that. There is an awakening right now, and we're starting to go ahead and see that the breath is a miracle, because you're not doing it. You can do it. That's me. But what does it when I don't think about doing it? Oh, it's the autonomic nervous system. Guys, shut up. Pseudoscience. Okay? No. Okay? Meditation is for you just to watch this miracle. So slow your brain down and see if you can get behind your mind. And watch the miracle of life. And watch this thing breathe you. This thing. It's not a guy or a girl. It's a thing. Okay? The Almighty. What is it? A guy? Why isn't it a girl? Okay? Well, I see there's a lot of guy things on this planet right now. And it doesn't look like the guy side of the fence is doing a good job. They've done a lot of destruction, a lot of murder, a lot of rape, a lot of famine, a lot of suffering, a lot of misery, and a lot of stuff that everybody doesn't want. Remember, critical thinking right now is to change yourself. You have to learn different techniques, okay? I'm like a medicine man, okay? Why? Because I'm studying plants, as many people do. And what do they do? And if you use them in combinations, look what they do, okay? So learn the terrain modification protocols. There's many different layers. And of course, make it a work of progress. I'm only giving you a certain layer. Maybe some of it's not right. Maybe most of it is at a level where if you take it, you can go ahead and enhance it, optimize it, or upgrade it. And that's all we're trying to do, okay? And do show your transformation. It's important for you to share. Remember, the voice chakra, you're sharing your experience, you're sharing your truth. You're starting to become a multidimensional, multifractional being, which you start to see, feel, hear, and touch, that you're connected to everything and everything, and all of a sudden you're getting your sanity. Why? It's because you don't feel so alone right now, okay? You don't feel so dysfunctional in your head. Is why? Because you've cleaned out heavy metals. You've cleaned out these demonic parasites. You stopped drinking blood and chewing on dead animals, okay? You stopped doing a lot of things, and you rebuilt yourself, and you went back to nature. And what's nature? Well, back to what we call no chemicals, no synthetics, no hormones, no antibiotics, no GMO. Okay? Learning about all these things and navigating them. You can't change the system, don't even try. Okay? You can do all the marches and rallies, whatever. All you can do is change yourself. And I can just give you some in spirit. It's from here. Inspiration. Okay, and enthusiasm in God. I do have some mind here. I'm connected to whatever you want to call the Creator God. Remember, we all are. Everything is. Okay, I'm not the quantity of this connection. I'm just a quality. That's it. One little tiny little ball of light in here. But you have to activate it. You have to activate it. And the only way I found out you can Okay, that's why people come up to our retreat here and you do 21 days terrain modification. You dry yourself out with a 7 or 14 day dry water fast. You get a series of IV therapies and different types of cutting edge therapies, colon hydrotherapy, okay, with different solvents and different types of deep massage and sauna, and you're trying to dry yourself out, okay, to rid yourself of the connection of the parasites that live in your body. You want to get sanity? Start learning fasting. Okay, getting IV therapies is very smart. Why? To start supporting dissolving, okay, heavy metals, plastics, okay, arsenic, thallium, stainless steel, opening regenerational channels, okay? Smart. Okay, so anyways, this was for YouTube. I just wanted to show you what I'm doing. Okay, I show how to do this, okay, how I did this, and many other videos that are private on Earth Through Academy. Okay, anyways, just real quick. It's $120 for 6 months. Does cost a lot of money to keep all that stuff going, let me tell you. Okay, website guys, this, that, programming, you'd be surprised. Hackers, mouthware, oh my gosh, okay? Video editing, camera equipment, video editing equipment, whatever it is, okay? We're not doing this to make money. In fact, we give you your money back. Remember, it's only $120 for 6 months. You learning the skin cleaning protocols, okay, the detoxing protocols for the skin and the rejuvenation, relubricating protocols for the skin. Remember, that's why I'm not being again arrogant. It's why my skin is so thin, is because I use the different solvents and I do the different guashing techniques, okay? And my body basically, okay, rids itself of all the accumulation so I can stay healthy. Is because why? Because I haven't accumulated. Remember, if you're fat, you're not fat, you're clogged. You're full of you know what, okay? But you're also full of heavy metals, you're also full of contaminants, you're also full of things that you don't need, okay? Demonic creatures, you can call those parasites, whatever you want to call them, wait till you see what they look like, and you're going to say, what is that? And it's a demonic creature. It's sucking your energy and sucking your life force, and when you get rid of those things, of course, they're not there anymore, so your life force has a lot of power to it. If not, these things will constantly, silently assimilate your energy and life force. And if you try to kill them, remember they are alive energy, they do have a directive as everything else does to breathe, and so everything else has a directive to live. Understand that. Do not kill the parasites. Again, terrain modify. Okay, learn the protocols. Okay, one last thing, okay, show you on YouTube. I also had a piece of glass that was stuck in my foot right here. I can't bend it over this way. Let me show you. Okay, and you can see it's totally healed now. I showed you the other day, I poked it with a needle, okay? It's hard to go ahead and see that, but I poked it with a needle. Let me turn the light on here. And I drained it, okay? Right now you can see that little mark, but nothing, okay? So, again, I soaked my feet, I squeezed. Remember, I'm doing self-doctoring. I'm not asking you to do this. I'm just showing you what I would do and what happens to you when you don't have anybody that you could go ahead and go to do it for you. Remember, do you want to have self-responsibility? Okay, then start learning. Start teaching. Start sharing. And start investigating. Don't believe everybody, especially the ones that have been our masters. Okay, remember, masters. It's time for you to be your own master. Remember, become your own doctor. Become your own critical thinker. Okay, your body remembers your holy land, so treat it so. Then this, as above, can go ahead and take its course. As above, so below. No, if your body's dirty, it's full of parasites, your body controls your mind. It tells you when to eat. It tells you what sexuality you are. Okay, a lot of confused people here. As you can see, men are turning to women and women turning to men because you got to learn why. Okay? You gotta learn why. Estrogen mimickers, very powerful, powerful, okay? And when you change transgender, where do you think your morphogenic value goes? Okay, it goes way down here. And this is where all the parasites live. They live in red, orange, and yellow. That's it, okay? Which is, keep this video under 25 minutes just to close it off. This is where the parasites live. Of course they do. They live right here, here, here. Right here, not in the heart, and you can get heartworms, but this is where the majority live. They live in the small intestine and this whole trunk, and you can see people from the side. Whoa, brother, what do you got in there, okay? Whoa, okay? No, that's not right, okay?
Those are passengers, guys, and for some odd reason, remember, these parasites are very smart. They don't want you to know. They don't even want you to hear this, and if they do, it's ludicrous. Mind-controlling parasites, and you have to run away. Why? It's because your little mind says, don't believe it. Guys, look it up, mind-controlling parasites. You think I'm making this up? These are very powerful possessions, okay? Smoking, you're not smoking, you're feeding the microbes that are living in your system. But the first few smokes you took, whoa! Until you've awakened a bacteria that will process the nicotine. Same with cannabis, same with alcohol. And once you do, then they tell you to feed. You don't need to smoke, you just need to get level. You're not gonna get high, you just get level. So once you stop smoking, what happened? You start getting aggravated. Your body starts going through addictions, going through withdrawal because you're not feeding your children. Stop eating meat. Okay, what happens? You start going through withdrawals. Okay, it's just what happens. You're going to go through turbulence. So slowly wean yourself off all addictions. Slowly wean yourself off sugar. Slowly wean yourself off garbage. Okay, slowly wean yourself off toxicity. Get a shower to chlorinator. Okay, slowly wean yourself off your cell phone. Okay, your Wi-Fi, shut it off at night. Come on, guys, okay? Critical thinking, wake up. Okay, enough ranting. Part two, these are all, like I said, good areas for you to get inspired, to be able to engage. Once you get sick, again, what are you gonna do? What are you gonna do? Are you gonna go to the doctor? Remember, they're sick too. And all they're gonna do is give you chemicals, synthetic chemicals, those are medicines they call them, pharmaceuticals. Or they're going to go ahead and say, you got the big C, cancer. What, maybe a parasite? You're toxic, you're demineralized, you're not having any mineralized water. Your body's nothing more than assaulted by thousands of chemicals every day. What do you think you get sick for? Eating GMOs, having mercury fillings. Come on, using shampoos with chemicals. You can't eat the shampoo, you don't put it in your hair. Okay, lotions, perfumes. Please, guys, wake up. So, okay, again, aloha. Aloha and good morning. Happy 4th of July. It's July 4th right now, and it's, let's see, it's 7:23 in the morning, July 4th, just to show you. And this is my 3.5 days after my not just cut, that was a wound I had in my leg. And so I'm going to show you now, 3.5 days later, of using these protocols, and this is very rapid healing. Okay, and I want to show you how rapid this is. So let's take a look. And this is how I bandage this here. I just use at night, during the day, I didn't put anything on it. All I do is keep an open dressing and I sprayed on some of my solutions, which I'll go over in a sec. But I use a cotton clean sock just at night so I don't hit it or scratch it and I protect it. But I keep it so it dries out. And I did go into the sun and really give it some sun until it was enough sun where I couldn't take it anymore because it was burning. Okay, so hard to get off with one hand here. Okay, and look at how this thing is healed. That's magical. Okay. So let me get this off here. Okay, so you can see very clearly, okay, that this wound, okay, I can point my toes, okay? Very simple. This thing is already healed. I can go on a run right now if I want. You notice no swelling, nothing, okay? Doesn't hurt. Okay, remember, this was just 3.5 days ago. Okay, I'd be keeping stitches in for the next week. Look at my thumb, okay? This was a massive gash, okay? Look. Okay, it doesn't hurt at all. Like I can push hard, move it back and forth. I don't feel a thing in there, okay? So this is rapid wound healing. And again, what I use is magnetics, okay? The magnetic generator, okay, which is right here. This is that zone, like spicy breakfast tea. Magnetic generator, I use that. Showed you how I use that. I did that once or twice a day. I soaked my feet, okay, in this solution here with TSP, borax, sodium bicarbonate, iodine, magnesium minerals, silica, hydrogen peroxide. That's the basic formula, okay? And that really helps get the garbage out of you, okay? Then again, I also used my probiotic DNA solution, which I was had it down to here, and I filled it just back up just a few minutes ago. I put water back in here. I put an ounce of sugar, some minerals, and some silica, and I'm back in business. I don't have to add my blood, my DNA into here. Okay? I don't have to add anything but sugar because the bacteria are just going to replicate, eat the sugar, replicate. The DNA's in the bacteria. Remember, I put my blood in there, about 20 drops, mixed it up. After about 3 days, you can do a test on here. There's no blood in here anymore. It's been eaten by the bacteria. So the bacteria now have the DNA of my DNA in the bacteria. So they're my bacteria now. Okay, they have my DNA in them. And so I put that on my wound. Okay, you can put that on your face for wrinkles. You can use this for douching, for colon hydrotherapy. You can use this for many, 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 many things. So I did spray the copper citrates, okay, a couple times a day. That's the 20 parts per million on top of the wound. And I also took 600 milligrams of ubiquinol, okay? Ubiquinol is a reduced form of coenzyme Q. Very smart to take if you're over 40 especially. Okay, it has to do with making your mitochondria, which you have 100 trillion cells, and 100 trillion cells each have a mitochondria, which is called the powerhouse of the cell, or the nuclear fission powerhouse, okay, of how you make energy, how you stay alive, how you have life force, how you regenerate. So these are all important parts of the pie. Remember, getting out in the sun, getting the information from the sun. So my electrical body, okay, I'm just going to show you. This is that spicy tea I'm having my breakfast to. So my electrical body, okay, which is the body that regenerates the cell. Remember, each cell is the same. Everyone in your body, your eyeball cell, your eyelash, hair, ear, okay, every cell in your body, your toenail, heart, muscle, nerve, okay, are all the same. They differentiate because of the electrical pattern, the architectural blueprint that's held within your ethereal aura, held within your architectural blueprint of member of your matricity, your electricity and your magnetic blueprint. So anyways, what I try to do is get as much dysfunction out of the joint, the assaulted joint, flesh or whatever injury I have. And I use magnetism. Remember, I went out in the sun to repolarize. I'm using, remember, iodine, okay? I'm using fulvic acid, okay? Magnesium concentrate, 31% brine. Living silica, live living silica. DMSO, dimethyl sulfoxides. Cannabis oil, ubiquinol, neem oil. And also I've taken niacin several times too to be able to release a lot of histamines out of me. Remember, if you do have pain, or if I have pain, what do? I use the copper salicylates, okay? The salicylates go in and they penetrate deep in and they have a analgesic effect, but also the copper goes in and wipes out a lot of any things that are feeding off of dead tissue, dead blood or anything else, because remember, your body is a microbe house. Some of the microbes, well, most of them should be good, and hopefully you don't have too many bad guys. But whatever's assaulted in your body, bacteria now have an opening to be able to get inside your body. So my cut on my ankle, let's look at it again. Okay, my cut on my ankle, okay, is a breach in my armor shield, my skin that keeps the outside world from getting in me. Okay, so you can see taking care of your feet, getting cuts on your hands and feet and everything. You have to disinfect and make sure not only from the outside in, but you gotta make sure that whatever's living in your body now doesn't go over there and make house, okay? Flesh-eating bacteria sometimes don't come from the outside of the body. How about they come from the inside of your body? Okay, remember there's certain things that are just waiting for you to be able to have an injury, waiting for parasites to gnaw on things to be able to cause inflammation, waiting for you to eat pesticides, insecticides, and herbicides and fungicides, okay, to irritate your intestinal wall, okay, waiting for you to take a shower in fluoride and chlorine, okay, waiting for you to put on chemical perfumes, okay, shampoo your hair with with chemical cleaners, so and conditioners. Okay, taking baths, okay, in fluoridated water, not so smart. Anyways, okay, these are all pieces to the pie that you have to actually look into, and that's why terrain modification is important. Okay, again, rapid wound healing. Okay, I'm on my three and a half days. This happened Friday at about 2 o'clock in the afternoon. Friday, Saturday, Sunday. Okay, and it's Monday right now at about 7 a.m. Okay, 3.5 days. It happened at about 2:30 in the afternoon Friday. Okay, so again, one last thing just to show you and verify how fast this is healing. Remember, I can jump, I can walk around, I can go on my toes. Okay, I'm not splitting anything. Okay? All right, so this is the power of healing rapidly. Remember, no stitches. No antibiotics that I used. Of course I used cacao butter. Remember, that's an antibiotic. Coconut oil has 8 different antibiotics in it, okay? And you don't go out in the sun on your cut unless you put the cacao butter on because you need an SPF 30, okay? If not, that new tissue will burn from the sun. It's new tissue. It doesn't have melanocytes. It's open. It's part of the tissue that's inside that's now getting exterior, okay, sunlight, but it'll sanitize it. You put the cacao butter on it, it does give it a 30 SPF. Okay, so that's 3.5 days. We'll go ahead and I'll show you maybe one more time how I do the dressing, but I'm gonna do the dressing the same way. I'm gonna use this iodine, again, fulvic, magnesium, living silica. I'm gonna put some DMSO on again because that really helps all the tissues become very lubricated. The fulvic acid, everything that we're putting on, the DMSO is just gonna take it in deeper. I'm also putting on the CBDs, and you know, you can, and there's a lot of ancient remedies about this. Big wounds, okay? Instead of me using a part of my DNA, okay, that maybe, well, you can get it from your sperm. You can put that on a wound, okay? How are you gonna get that out of you? Well, you can. then take it out and put it on your wound, okay? Someone else's too if you wanted to. But there are other ways if you wanted to go ahead and get regenerative light cells, okay? Remember, live things have energy. Sperm, each one of them have a huge light bulb on the top of their head. Remember, there's up to like 300 million sperm per square cubic centimeter. Anyways, there's a lot of life force in that. That's why you make babies with it. But what I've done is I've taken my blood and I've put them in the bacteria. And this bacteria, remember, doesn't just have 16. We've cultivated lots of bacteria. I have as many as I can go ahead and put in here with my DNA. And like I said, once you put it in once, the bacteria will have it in there. I never bring the solution down to anything more than halfway. Then I just fill it back up with water, sugar, minerals, and silica back again. Okay, so then I use this. That's a topical on my cells, and these cells help my cells, as I found out, regenerate me because they are me. Okay, so anyways, just food for thought. Okay, that's good. I'm gonna go on the steam sauna right now, and you know, I've been taking showers every day. It's been getting wet. I go on the steam sauna, it's about 140 degrees probably. Okay, so I'm not keeping it dry, but then again, I'm not drenching it either. Okay, so, okay, I'll be back. All right. Aloha, good morning. It's July 5th right now. It's early morning, Tuesday, and I want to show you my 4.5 day right now, my wound that I have. Okay, so my thumb's really good right now. Okay, you can see I can push it back and forth. There's no pain at all. And that was, like I said, super deep gash. And my ankle, I slept with my sock on. And this thing right here is, it looks sort of pretty ugly because I didn't put any stitches in it. Remember, I didn't even pull it together. I could have put Steri-Strips on it, but I wanted to sort of do an experiment. Like, I'm out in the middle of nowhere and I gotta heal this thing and I don't have anything to go ahead and hold it together, stitch it together or anything. So I'm just doing an experiment right now. I know it's gonna heal either way, but I'm trying this. This is the hardest way to make something heal. Remember, I had to walk. I walked yesterday about a mile
okay, all around the farm. And you can see I can point my toe, okay? I can move it around, I can touch it, okay? No big deal. Okay, so it's not bleeding or anything, and it's got a little bit of hardness in the middle here because it's just all sealing together right there. So yesterday, you know, I'm not just laying down with this leg. I'm walking around all over the place, and I did hit it yesterday against the box, so that's one thing you got to watch. But fast healing, remember, is making sure, okay, look, if I had inflammation or I had some type of infection, this thing right here, I wouldn't be able to touch it. It would be super sore, okay? And it'd be oozing out pus and it'd be swollen, okay? That's not a good sign. So, and there's multiple things that I would do if I had that, okay? Multiple things. I'd be drinking also maybe some copper salicylates, copper citrates, maybe even some MMS, okay? Chlorine dioxin, like I said before. I even could do silver and or maybe three or four or five drops of 35% hydrogen in 16 ounces of water, okay, H2O2, food grade. Okay, there's all different things you could go ahead and do. I may even want to clean my blood for 2 or 3 hours, okay, with the pulser, okay. I may want to use, again, the magnetic generator or the magnets. There's all variety of different things. I may want to put my feet back into the bags right here. Okay. These ones here and suck out more inflammation. I haven't used those in the last couple of days because my foot hasn't had inflammation or anything else. In the first 2 days, I wanted to make sure I didn't have anything that was going to go ahead and, because I did cut my tendon. So I'm going to go in the shower right now. And then I'm just going to go ahead and treat it the same way I did before. I'm only treating it once a day right now. I don't need to put any more. I do spray the copper citrates in this bottle here, 20 parts per million on there, 2-3 times a day. It's because I'm not putting a bandage on it or anything. So, okay, in the shower. Okay, guys, aloha. Aloha and good morning. I'm just going to show you a little quick update. Now it's 5.5 days since I've had my really good wound or cut that you want to call it, and I did this, remember, the way that if I never had stitches, I didn't close the wound up, I just let it heal, and it was a big gash. And this is, you can see how this has healed beautifully. This is my sock. That what I do is I put the sock on to be able to cover it only at night. I don't cover it during the day, I just let it go open. And you can see how that's healed very nicely, okay? There's no pain or soreness. And what I can do is I can point my toes perfect, okay? I can bend. I'm gonna go on about a 0.5-mile run today just to go ahead and test it out. Remember, this is 5.5 days. That cut was all the way across, okay, separated. You can see the separation. So all that tissue in between there had to heal in between, okay, and glue itself together. Okay, remember, look, there's no swelling. You see the vein right there. Okay, remember, I had blood all the way down into here because I did cut the vein. And I did cut the tendon in there too because it was really sore first 2 days. That's why I soaked my feet, remember, with the bags because I had inflammation. I did use ice the first few days. Because I needed to, because it was really sore. It's like 6:30 in the morning right now. I'm just gonna jump in a steam shower. And I do keep an open dressing all the time. Even though I live in Hawaii, and I have hit it a couple of times. I hit it yesterday against a box. So, you know, rapid wound healing, remember, is also making sure you don't re-injure the wound. Making sure that you don't get an infection. If you get an infection, you can't heal. That's the reason why it gets infected, okay, because you have an infection. So if it doesn't hurt, okay, or it doesn't have pus on it or anything, or doesn't have swelling, it's because it doesn't have an infection, because this is a bad spot right here. Remember, it's down by the floor next to dirt. Everything that's coming up, remember, all little particles of rat poop or just touching it at all, okay? So remember, I've put the copper citrates on top. I've used the topical, remember, iodine, okay, fulvic acid,
silica, okay, magnesium. Okay, I did use DMSO several times, which really soothed everything and pushed everything inside. And then I sealed it up with coconut oil and cacao butter. Okay, and I did this treatment twice a day, morning and evening. Okay, but when you put the liquids on, okay, definitely you'll feel it. So it does penetrate deep. You'll feel it penetrate deep. And remember, strep or staph, flesh-eating bacteria, you got to stop it. You got to make sure that the terrain can't modulate, okay, its life. So you have to make it so there are certain things there that make it so these bacteria cannot colonize, and they can't replicate, and they can't feed. Remember, I also use the magnets, okay? And I use these magnets for probably 5 minutes at a time, maybe twice a day, okay? And remember, I used the, let me just put this right here and I'll show you. I don't want to get the magnets next to my phone. But what I did was, if I had my ankle up like this, okay, what I do is, remember, there's three different fields here. A pulling field, okay, pushing field, which is number two field, and number three field is turning the magnets around 180 degrees. That's number three field, number three field, number two field, and number one field. Three different fields. So what I do is I slowly rotate the magnets, and you can feel they're pulling. Okay, and I give this all different magnetism up and down my whole leg here. Okay, even though this, you think it doesn't do anything, no, it's not true. Okay, and what you're doing is that you're just remodulating all of the electric patterns in here. Remember, everything runs on dielectric, okay? North-south, north-north, south-south. Those are the three energies. So what I'm doing, I'm just giving a variety of energies through there. Okay? This does work. Okay? At least I've found it out to be. I'm also laying, like I said, I'm laying on my magnetic mattress, which I'll show you, which really not only is helping me dissolve a lot of things that's in my body. Okay, this is one of the things I found out. The magnetic mattress, using it plus, minus, plus, minus, plus, minus, positive, negative, okay? helps dissolve, oxalates, okay, and a lot of different things that live in the body that's not coming out easily. You put magnets on your pipe, remember, and it takes out the calcifications out of your pipe, okay? So we also, remember, this is static magnetism, and then we used, I used pulse magnetism. Okay, and the pulse magnetism you got to learn about. Okay, these do have an affinity for stopping microbial colonization, number two, helping with regeneration. Okay, it does. Play with it yourself, figure out what you want to do with it. But if you read the research and you really do it, I've been playing with electrical magnetics 15 years. When you really read the research, there's a lot of deep research on electrical magnetic pulse, medicinal therapies. Okay, so, okay, that was it. I just wanted to show you again. Okay, remember, 5.5 days. I haven't even got my stitches out yet if I would have had these. Remember, I didn't seal, I didn't pull this together, but you can see how it pulled together here. And it's filling in this tissue in the center right here, okay? So this is, remember, the worst way that you could go ahead and heal a wound is to keep it open as it heals. You got to pull it together, but I'm doing it this way here. I want to see how the body actually has to deal with growing all that extra tissue, bridging that tissue across there versus me just sealing it tight. And if I put Steri-Strips on this, that would have been 10 times smarter. But remember, I'm not just doing this just to heal it fast. I'm experimenting to see what if I didn't have Steri-Strips, and Steri-Strips are to pull, it's not stitches, but it's to use like a Band-Aid, a stick-em, to be able to pull the tissues together. You know, you go to the emergency hospital and they'll use crazy glue. That's what they use, okay, to stick tissues together sometimes, okay?
The closer the tissue, the less it has to make that bridge. And this is where the possibility is, where your body may not make it fast enough and microbes get on there. And now they have a chance to get in your body. And that's what makes all this infection. Okay, so like I said, I used iodine, I used the folic acid to dissolve things. Iodine is to be able to disinfect, okay, and also help with regeneration. We use the silicas, rebuilding particles, rebuilding what you call material, okay, to rebuild the tissue because it needs silica, collagen. Magnesium and conductivity, magnesium chloride, okay, that's for the conductivity. And for an array of minerals to help rebuild, topical. It's not just even nutritional through the mouth. Remember, this is topical. This is making it so it's available right there. It doesn't have to get anywhere from the body, okay? It's on top of the body, so that's a smart way to be able to also bring in nutrients, is to use them topically. And then I sealed it off, like I said, with the coconut oil and cacao butter, which is antibiotic, okay, and also has lauric acid to help with regeneration. Necessary to go ahead and put the oils on. Okay, there you go, guys. Aloha.
Aloha, good morning. I'm gonna give you a quick update. It's been now about 12 and a half days since I had my wound in my leg. My thumb is pretty much completely healed, okay? That's nothing. That was healed long ago. And that was a good puncture, remember? No infection, no pus, nothing. Remember, I didn't cover it. I didn't put a Band-Aid on it. You wanna make sure that nothing can get in it, but I was doing an experiment to be able to make sure that, well, the different products that I'm using, okay, actually work. I'm gonna keep my wound open. I'm not gonna do any band-aiding to it or anything else or covering it up. As you can see, I didn't stitch my leg. It was a big wide gash, and I actually ran into it the other night in the middle of the night going to the bathroom. I smacked the wall corner of the door, okay? But you can see how it healed perfect right here, and it's not sore a bit, okay? And I ran 2 miles with it the other day, no swelling, okay? No swelling anywhere, all the blood's gone, okay? And of course, there's no pain. And I can bend it back and forth, it doesn't split apart.
So the idea is that it didn't get an infection, okay? I didn't cover it up, okay? We're in Hawaii here, and staph, strep, all different types of infections, okay, are rampant. Just because humidity. A lot of people have weak immune systems, so what you have to do is have a strong immune system. But I also did other protocols. Remember, I used lots of different things, from probiotic bacteria. I even put on one time, I put on some live egg yolk. Okay, this works really good for wounds. Okay, it's got to be a fertile egg. Try to get it on the third day. If you haven't seen the Miracle of Egg series yet, then you want to go ahead and watch that, because the eggs are full of nutrients, but not only that, stem cells and life force. It's not easy to get your eggs, so, you know, because they are stem cells, you can use a variety of different things to be able to go ahead and rebuild it, which I was going over, okay? My DNA drink that I made from my probiotic bacteria, I use that in there. I used, again, remember, I did hit it, it did split, it didn't bleed, but it split, and I said, ah, okay, no big deal. I haven't dressed it just to let you know, let me show you here. I'm gonna show you in my backyard, and I spent 2 hours yesterday in the garden right here, okay, up here in my planters, but down in the garden, you can see that I rototilled this whole ground all the way around. Okay, and so of course I was working, and of course didn't have any problems. I even went on a 2 mile run, okay? So remember, it's the whole idea is not only how fast the wound heals, yeah, make sure you just don't hit it. I hit mine like 3 times so far. It's in a bad spot, because when you're walking, you just have to be very careful. I hit it on the door on the car too. So you want to go ahead and use steri strips, and you can make those with, I'll show you how to make those. You can make those with surgical tape, but you want to make sure, you know, steri strips are very thin in the middle, okay, and they're thick in the back, and you want to make sure that the tape that goes across the wound has another piece of tape on the backside so it doesn't have stickum on there, so it's not going to pull when you pull the steri strips off, which you shouldn't take them off anyways for about 5 or 6 days. But that's another way. That's the way I would have did it. And of course, it would have been way healed more right now. But I wanted to do this the hardest way I could. Okay? And
keep it open to infection and see if what I'm putting on, okay? And all I've put on the last couple of days is the copper citrates, okay? I just give it a spray. Just put a spray on there like that. And just let it soak in. And then I cover it with cacao butter. If it did have an infection, again, I'd be using my iodine, I'd be using my fulvic acid, I'd be using my concentrations, okay, of many different things. And maybe some topicals of the copper salicylates. Why? Because I may have pain. So I have pain analgesics. So you have to have all these things ready to go. So when you do have a problem, you got yourself your little laboratory, okay? If you don't have the doctor, well, better figure it out, because if you get an infection, that's the worst thing. Getting an infection, okay? You can always get alternative treatment for many different things, okay? But no matter what, even if you get surgery and you get stitches and everything, you get an infection, you're in trouble. And I see lots of people that go to surgery and they get massive infections. They get them sometimes from the hospital, MRSA and all different things. So, okay, just wanted to show you that. Okay, again, the infection is the biggest picture. Just wanted to make sure that these solvents and different things that I'm using, these protocols, okay, these mineralizations, the silica, okay, the magnesium, okay, all these pieces, did they benefit myself, okay, from getting an infection? No, they took away all infection because I didn't get any, and I did cut the tendon. Again, one more time here. I did cut the tendon so I couldn't move my leg up and down too much, and of course there's no swelling anywhere. Okay, so, all right, here we go. I'll give you another update in a few days. All right, bye. Aloha and good morning. We're gonna give you an update, my last update on my wound I had on my ankle, and of course, my thumb. And it's almost been now, it's Tuesday. It's gonna be 3 weeks on Friday. And I wanna show you, the biggest idea I want to put in your head, okay, is that if you didn't have antibiotics, if you didn't have a way to be able to stitch your wound, okay, or if you didn't have a way to be able to even close it, okay, what would you do? So what I did was an experiment and it came out beautiful, okay? Remember, I didn't get an infection, that was number one. I did hit it a few times to be open up the wound again, but let me show you. This is coming up 3 weeks here, and this thing is totally healed. And you can see how I can bend it, I can do anything. And the glue that's across here right now, this was a deep cut. Remember, it even went into the tendon here. Okay, so remember, the idea is once you get an infection, then the wound is corrupted. Okay, it won't heal easy, and not only that, you're gonna get scar tissue. Scar tissue means that it's gonna take way longer for it to heal, okay? Flesh-eating bacteria is the problem. And so what you're trying to do is stop the flesh-eating bacteria. So we've talked about stopping flesh-eating bacteria on your enamel, okay, of your teeth. We've talked about flesh-eating bacteria, okay, of the gums, receding gums. And once you go ahead and see that you can stop flesh-eating bacteria, other than the normal modes of treatment, then you may want to go ahead and give this a try, because a lot of times you can even do the pharmacological approach and it won't stop it. So these are what I call holistic ways that I've learned over the years to be able to deal with medical, sometimes not emergencies, but semi-emergencies. And a lot of times there's not doctors around. And if there are, a lot of times you might not go ahead and get the best care that you need. Okay, so it's always good to learn yourself, become your own doctor, experiment on yourself. But then again, have discernment. I'm only showing you what I did. I'm not asking you to do what I did. Okay, remember I used a variety of different therapies, magnetics, okay, pulse generator. I soaked my feet. Okay, and various solutions. I had to use ice because it was really sore. Okay, I used a combination of iodine, remember, fulvic acid with the copper. Okay, copper citrates I put on every day. And coated it and also protected it with cacao butter and coconut oil. So, you know, there's lots of different things you can do to be able to stop infection, but the biggest thing is to stop infection
when affection occurs, which is in the beginning of a cut or a wound. That's why they always want to clean it out really good. So I found out using these techniques, okay, are very, well, repeatable, okay, is because I've done this to many people that have had bad strep infections. I said, look, you've tried everything else, let's try this. So there are different protocols that we all need to experiment with. And if you do come up with something that's worthwhile, you want to share it if you can. I only put these videos that we have here on Earther Academy only because, well, it's because a lot of the protocols are not run-of-the-mill, you know, as far as the mainstream. So, you know, we're all trying to figure out, remember, how to stay healthy, wealthy, happy, and wise. So I hope you learned a few things from this. And you may want to have some of these staples in your house, just like Band-Aids. Remember, iodine, fulvic acid with the piece of copper inside. So it'll dissolve some of the copper, which is one of the best fungal agents. And I found out that the fulvic acid with the boron, it also stops bleeding, okay? Stops infection. So they've done lots of studies with this. They were actually even gonna make some Band-Aids with fulvic acid and different types of things. And this is where I've just sort of connected the dots together and tried different types of things to be able to see when I have a problem or when I see other people have problems that they can't figure out how to stop. Okay, so remember, I also used a lot of live food. Remember, live food. This is my little garden here. Okay, I'm growing mustard, lettuce right here, arugula, more basil, okay? And you can see this is dill seed now, and I'm gonna take the seeds and I'll make myself an herb. And we've got all different types of arugula and tomatoes. And these are the arugula seeds right here. Okay, and each one of these pods, okay, that make a flower, each one of these pods here have about 13 seeds in them. And that's gonna give me one seed, gives me a plant, arugula plant. And here's a tomato, this is live food. And the only way you can get live food, guys, is you gotta grow it, okay? I also use the sun, remember, very important. I go out in the sun every day, okay? Why? So I can get new information from the sun. Our bodies are connected to the sun, connected to the earth, connected to the plants, connected to the animals, connected to everything. So, you know, I try to really use, like I showed you, the miracle of eggs. Okay, the stem cells, the growth hormone that's in these eggs for regeneration power. Watch those videos. Give things a try. And then let's go ahead and actually share what happens. Remember, these are not specific recipes at all. Bend them around. Remember, it's all an experiment. And what I do is experiment every day. I research every day. And if something actually makes more sense than what I was doing yesterday, then I'm going to change what I was doing yesterday. Yesterday I thought was the right thing to do. And today, I'm gonna change it up, experiment, and when I find something better, guess what? I change it up, okay? So this is 35 years of changing it up, okay, guys? Okay, I just wanted to show you again one last thing. 3 weeks, no infection, that's the big picture here, okay? And it doesn't hurt at all, okay? And I played on the trampoline, I ran around the other day, okay? I went on 2 mile runs, okay, and I've been doing that 7 days after I had this injury. So again, if you do get an infection, there are other protocols, because you have to go ahead and sometimes take things internally to be able to stop infection too, and we went over some of that. I also used ferments on my wound, the ferments that I take inside my body to heal my gut wall flora. Remember, your gut wall flora, okay, control your whole body, all your brain chemicals, your hormones, a lot of things. Remember, everything is connected. I'm getting D3 right now in the sun, okay? And the sun is actually energizing me and giving me new information. Of course it is, okay? Follow the skin cleaning protocols. Don't get out in the sun unless you actually have cacao butter, coconut oil, the magnesium minerals, the silica, and you've cleaned your skin thoroughly everywhere, okay? With the vodka solutions, with the minerals, not without the minerals. Vodka by itself, is like any alcohol, it's poison. Sugar, okay, is, again, I don't have that in my diet. I really cut my sugar down to basically hardly any at all, unless it's fresh fruit, okay? okay? Or fresh vegetables that have some sugar in it. Sugar, remember, is not what you think it is. You really want to train your body to be able to take the higher energy forms, like plasma from the sun, plasma from live plants. That's why you need a garden, okay? A garden. Here's my little garden. And rip out your back lawn and put a garden in. Okay, I'm just redoing my garden now. This is 2 weeks right now. This is one package of arugula. Wow, do I got a lot of food in 2 weeks. Those are about a year old over there, and they just keep on making new collard leaves, okay? New leaves, actually those are cabbage. So I'm gonna show you an experiment a little later. Also how you can see real quick here. This is tobacco here, and this is a tobacco plant that we just kept in here. You can see it's flowering, okay? But you can see that this tobacco plant is the same age as this tobacco plant right here, these two. And you can see how different they are. They don't even look the same. Okay, that's over 4 feet tall. And look at all the flowers. It's got 10 sets of flowers on it. Okay, and that's what happens when you put minerals, bacteria, and you put the correct terrain in the soil. The plants grow the right way. Okay, so again, let's just look at that one more time. Look at the difference. This isn't tobacco. I don't even know what this is. I guess it is. Okay, and you can see it's got a couple of flowers, and most of these didn't even spurt. And here's the other tobacco plant. So we put two on the ground, and we put two up just in their containers here. So, okay, there we go, guys. We'll see you next time. And, you know, research every day. You got to go ahead and add more awareness to your mind. Remember, what you see on the mainstream information most likely is not really what you need. So you need not only alternative media, I would watch that also because most of that has a lot of disinformation. I would go to the alternative media. That makes a little more sense. Okay, guys, aloha.